السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today we are completing the fifth episode or the fifth part of Towards Effective Civil Society Organization and talk about volunteerism and its values and objectives. And I thank my colleagues Ahmed Sheikh and Maher and Sahar for helping me. And if you want to join any of my social media platforms, please do so. Why volunteerism? Values and objectives. Okay? Because why we talk about volunteerism? Because volunteerism is one of the main tools or the main principles or the main directions which will lead to all this. Which will lead to all these points. Point number one, positive consumption of the young people's energy and what benefits the society or ourselves. Yani, the most important thing a young man or young woman is having is the energy that they have. This energy has to be utilized positively or negatively. If the state or the government or the responsible people in the society would like to use such an energy constructively, they have to direct it towards building local civil society or local community or a local project to help those people. If it was left, it could be wasted. Some of the youth or the young people could consume it positively, some could not. So we don't want to waste their energy. So the first objective is to consume the young people's energy more positively to benefit their society. It's number one. Number two, young people will gain more skills to deal with different social problems. If we send a group of young people to Africa and ask them to do water projects, they will know, is this water project is just digging a well, digging a canal, making a lake, making a reservoir, and so they will be able to gain new skills of building water project or orphanage or organizing a conference or organizing a workshop or making a research paper or making a presentation and so on and so on. So these skills actually will let the young people to be able to deal with different social problems. Number three, gaining more trust. In what? First, trust is in yourself. The more you expose yourself, to the outside world, the more you stand to meet the challenge, the more that you'll be able to be confident in yourself and confident in your ability to find solution, not only to meet the challenge, but to find solution to the community problem. Once you stood up for a problem and you understood it is depth, dimension, its roots, you'll be able to find the solution for such a problem. You might not find it from the first time, but you'll be able to find it second and third and fourth time. Number four, young people will get more skills for what? To work collectively as a teamwork. Quite often we don't know how to work as a teamwork. That's why we work on an individual basis, because it's more easy, it's faster. But if you work amongst the team, they will delay you, they will nag you, they will give you a headache. And this is what's not a part of the curriculum virtue, curriculum in the West. In the curriculum, inside the curriculum of the West, they train the young children to work as a team from the age of 7 or 8 or 9 in a group to enable them to become a skillful or knowledgeable team workers and get the skills of becoming a team member. Number five, increasing their loyalty, see, to their societies and the countries. The more we expose the young people to the community, to the societies, the more we get them out of their ghettos, from the avenues, the streets, the villages, the districts, into the wider country and different communities and to be exposed to different people, different societies. They will realize that actually their society is not only a small society in the village, but actually it's the bigger society of the country, and be more loyal not only to defend their own society and own community, but actually to defend the whole country. Exploiting the young people, number six, to the real problems affecting their society. We send you to a very poor, stricken, poverty-stricken area. Lot of maybe refugees, maybe displaced people, maybe orphans, maybe widows, maybe unemployed, maybe elderly people, maybe sick people, whatever. All these problems, maybe climate change, drought, and famine, and also, once you are there with your vision and with your ability, you'll be able to be exposed to the depth of the problem of such community and such society, so you'll be able to, oh wow, how can we help you? By saying how can I help you, that means that you are trying to find the solution to that problem, and as far as the fact you want to be able to sort out this problem. So the sooner you are exposing yourself to this society, the sooner you become able to think positively on finding a solution for the problem. Also, by training them, by getting these skills and training those young people, you'll be able to create the future leaders. Because as I mentioned earlier in a previous talk, about we should, while we are in position as presidents, as kings, as queens, as ministers, as prime ministers, as responsible people, as CEOs or chairmen of societies, to create the second and third leadership inside our society, inside our community, inside our country. So we have to build, keep building the future leadership for our society. Sometimes when we engage the young people in some of the national projects, we might not need a lot of skilled people, but we need casual people, casual workers. And with those casual workers, if they become volunteers, from the people who are volunteering, will save a lot of cost in building the budget of such a project. And this is what in some of the countries, the military service, from the army, if they have got an economical win inside the country, which I'm against it, actually they use the conscript because they are there as free labor forces. So those people who are coming to do the military service, they will be used by the military to build very expensive projects with no cost, because they are a part of the people who are doing the military service. They are free, what they call it, free labor force. And promoting and spreading the culture of communication, networking, cooperation, and partnership. You might go to a team which is made from some young people from the north, or from the south, from the east, from the west, or from different countries. From maybe European countries, from maybe American countries, from maybe African countries, from maybe Asian countries, and so on. And this kind of teamwork will spread a new culture of networking before and after the event, organized, or before and after the projects that we are working together. Like yes, I travel with quite a few volunteers from different parts of the world. If I can take an example from Canada, see some volunteers came from 5 or 6 or 7 cities with their families, with their children, with their husband, with their mother, and so on and so. And they start to know another from this city and this city and this city and this city. It could happen also to yourself and your society in different parts of the world. This will enable you to believe in the culture of communication, networking, cooperation, and partnership. And these 4 points become nowadays like a necessity, or absolute, or crucial necessity for the success of any work, any community work, any social work, any political work, any economical work, any work that we are doing for our community and society. Also, volunteerism or volunteering will lead us to discover the abilities and the qualities inside every young individual. the skills which he or she doesn't know about it, or they might be doing. Like actually, we found amongst our young people very talented artists. They can do beautiful drawing. When they sit down with you in a room and they do these beautiful images, say, oh wow, this is very good. Come on. So you have to take such an individual and take him out to develop his or her skill. Maybe writing a lot of poems, maybe writing novels, maybe writing dramas, maybe acting, maybe running, maybe become a sport athlete and all these sorts of things. You cannot discover it unless you put them in this spot of volunteerism, which each one of them will be able to use their potential to the maximum to please their local community. Also, it will treat many social and psychological problems affecting the society. Nowadays, we talk about depression. Now, take about the growing rate of suicide amongst young people. Actually, whether it wasn't the good old days, it was in the West, particularly in the Scandinavian countries, because the young people did not have anything to do, everything provided by the state. Nowadays, it goes out from such northwest into the central, into the east, and into the south as well. So, the depression. So once you get them out of this area by volunteering, you will be able to treat depression by social means, not actually by medical means. Encouraging young people to make and lead initiatives. You can bring the young people to the room and you tell them, you take this one, go. You take this one, peace, and go. And you take this piece, and go. The component of one project could be taken by four or five small working teams amongst the volunteers, and they come back to you in a competitive way, enabling them to talk about what was the initiative, was it successful or not. Training young people on preparedness. Be prepared and ready all the time. Be ready all the time for a disaster, be ready all the time for any problem to affect the community. That's why we go from the process of putting the philosophy and the culture of volunteerism at the back of the mind of the society and the community and the individual into the process of building a system of volunteerism inside the individual, so he or she will be putting their name on the volunteer list anytime be to called on by this organization or this department. And to be ready all the time, you have to be continuously trained in such subject you are going to address with them. Volunteerism also will increase my belief in my values, my belief in the values of my community, my culture, my history, and my faith with inside my country. This will connect me to understand and know and realize that the beautiful values and culture and history and faith of my country and my people. Volunteerism also, number 15, is exposing. The volunteer will be exposed to what? To different lifestyles in the community. They don't have to be poor. If we take a country like Pakistan, if you go to the north, as in the good old days called Northwest Frontier, NWF, with a tribal area with different culture in different languages. If you go to the south, southeast, and southwest, southeast will be Baluchistan, which is about 50% of the country. Huge land with a different culture, different language could be, different history, different climate. If you go to the Sindh, on the southwest, we'll find the Sindhi are different. If you go to the center, where is Nahur and Punjab is different because very agricultural area. If you go to Kashmir, mountainous area, and so on. So this inside the same country, there are different cultures and different history and could be different languages as well. And different style of life. Even the food is different. the Pakistani food is not the same, the Indian food is not the same, the Egyptian food is not the same, the Saudi food is not the same, even the English, the English and British food, the Scotch and the Welsh and the Irish and the Anglo-Saxon, their food even is different to one another. And the lifestyle is different, and the code of dress is different. So exposing them to different lifestyles in the community and countries. Realizing and enjoying the beautiful habitat. See, go out. As I mentioned Pakistan before, and I can mention Afghanistan, I can mention Philippines, I can mention Indonesia. Look at the habitat around you. Go to the Amazon and go to the depth of the forest there, or in Africa, or in the Bengal, Bay of Bengal, or in India, and see all this habitat, the beautiful ones, where you enjoy seeing, or even Tanzania and Western Kenya and the national parks, and national parks actually in South Africa, and all this connected to see the different creation of God and how different creations of God and how God subhanahu wa ta'ala was putting his fingerprint on every creation in this area, so you'll enjoy the beautiful habitats, climate, and various living life in their societies. Also, when you are doing this kind of volunteering, you will be able to weave new. Listen to this, and you have to listen to it very carefully. And if you want to have the written statement of the presentation, I can give it to you. Weaving new, cohesive, diverse, accommodating, and inclusive social fabrics in their society. To allow what? To allow positive and smooth coexistence between different communities. This is beautifully written by my colleague. Volunteerism will lead to new cohesive, weaving of new cohesive, diverse, accommodating and inclusive social fabric in their societies to allow positive and smooth coexistence between different communities. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Increasing the abilities of young people to become breadwinners, because they'll be able to see how to start the project, to manage the project, and to end the project. How to meet the challenges, to face the challenges, and supersede the challenges, and make the positive results. Increasing the abilities to become breadwinners, and creating or finding new job opportunities. You don't have all the time to go back to the government and tell them, give me a job, or to a company, give me a job. You can make your own company, you can create your own market when you believe in yourself. Number 19, being more serious and responsible in what they say and do. Yani, in the good old days when I used to work as an individual, I can do whatever I want and I can escape or fool myself. If I start to work as a volunteer and I start to be working amongst a team work, I will be responsible for what I say, because I am working with other 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 people. And what I want to do, because I cannot fool our people and other people as well as I cannot fool myself. Increasing their abilities to build what? Of competitiveness. When the people now qualified from the university or not, oh, I can't find a job. Go and make a job for yourself. Go and keep trying. Keep knocking the doors. I applied for 20 jobs. Go for 40 jobs. Go for 50 jobs. Go for 100 jobs. Keep going. As I mentioned earlier on to one of my colleagues here, I went to the same interview 3 times. I was the only candidate and I was not getting the job. 3 times. I was the only candidate in the hospital to apply for the job, and I did not get the job. Okay? So increasing their capabilities of competitiveness to build their societies and compete with one another. Number 21, being able to defend their, this is very important. You become a volunteer, your loyalty to the country increase, and you believe in your country, you believe in your values, you believe in your faith, your history and your culture. So whenever you are in a regional meeting or a national meeting or an international global meeting, you stand up to defend your culture, your history, your heritage, your values, your faith, your people, your state, your country. I think In a nutshell, these are some of why we want to do volunteering to complement the other four, the previous talk about the definition of volunteering. So today, if I need to conclude what I've been mentioning for the last maybe 10, 15 minutes or 20 minutes, I'll go back to the first slide. Why volunteerism and by an objective, okay, keep moving please, and you're consuming the energy, gaining skills, getting more trust in myself, gaining new skills again, of working as a teamwork, next one, increasing our loyalty to societies, exploiting that people to their problems affecting societies, building the future leaders, providing cheaper working force, promoting and spreading the culture of communication, networking, cooperation, and partnership, discovering skills, abilities, and the qualities found in the young people, treating many social problems and psychological problems, encouraging young people to make and lead their initiatives, training young people to be prepared all the time, readiness and preparedness, increasing the belief and value of our countries, exposed different style lifestyle and lifestyle in exposure, more exposure to different lifestyles, realizing and enjoying the beautiful of the habitat surrounding us. I will read this one because I like it very much. Weaving new cohesive, diverse, accommodating and inclusive social fabrics in the society to allow positive and smooth coexistence between different communities, then increasing abilities to become breadwinners, being more serious and responsible for what they do, gives them competitiveness, okay, and defend our countries in regional and international arena. So with this, completing the five parts of the first part of why the first slide please, why towards actually towards effective civil society organization, this is episode number 5. I hope in episode number 6 we'll talk about the job description. I hope in episode number 6 also orphan sponsorship and the definition of orphans and the other topics that we need to discuss with you. Assalamu alaikum.